Till now, we have seen the classification of instructions based on length, based on functions, addressing modes of AD85 microprocessor. Already we know what is machine cycle, what is T state. These things we were studying in first unit, correct? Let's see the summary of AD85 instruction set. So, the first type is data transfer group. So, this group contains 13 types of instructions. The first one is move R1, R2. That is move register R2 to register R1. Okay, the content of register R2 is move to register R1. That is the function of move R1, R2. So move R1, R2 is nothing but the content of register R2 is moved to register R1. This is a single byte instruction. This is register addressing mode. Here it needs only one machine cycle. Number of T states 4. So this is about move R1, R2. For example, move A, B, move A, C, move B, D, like that. Okay. So, move R1, R2 is nothing but move register to register. The second instruction is move R, M. That is move memory to register. The content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair. Okay. The content of memory location. Memory location is nothing but HL register pair is moved to register R. Okay, that this is the function of move R, M. So this is single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 2. Number of T states 7. Then third type, that is move M, R. That is move register to memory. The content of register R is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in register pair HL. Okay, so this is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 2. Number of T states 7. Fourth type MPIR, data 8 bits. That is move immediate data to register. Okay, the function is the content of byte 2 of the instruction is moved to register R. So this is the function of MPIR, data 8 bits. Okay, the content of byte 2 of the instruction is moved to register R. It is a 2 byte instruction. This is immediate addressing mode. Machine cycles 2. Number of T states 7. Fifth one, MPIM, data 8 bits. That is move immediate data to memory. Okay. The content of byte 2 of the instruction is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in register pair HL. Okay. This is the function of MVIM, data 8 bits. The content of byte 2 of the instruction is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair. So it is a 2 byte instruction. This is immediate or register indirect addressing mode. It needs 3 machine cycle. Here 10 T states needed for this. Then 6th type LXI RP. RP is nothing but register pair. LXI RP data 16 bits. Okay. So that is load immediate register pair. The function of this type of instruction is byte 2 of the instruction is moved to low order register. Okay, byte 2 of the instruction is moved to low order register RL of the pair RP, and byte 3 of the instruction is moved into the high order register RH of the pair. So this is the function of LXI RP data 16 bits. It is a 3 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, machine cycles 3, Number of these states, 10. Then seventh type, LDA address 16 bits. That is, load accumulator direct. The content of memory location whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction is moved to the accumulator. So this is the function of LDA address 16 bits. It is a 3 byte instruction. Direct addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 4. Number of T states 13. Okay, then 8th type STA address 16 bits. That is store accumulator direct. The content of the accumulator is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction. So this is a 3 byte instruction, direct addressing mode, number of machine cycles 4, number of T states 13. 9th type LHLD address 16 bits. That is load H and L direct. The content of memory location whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction is moved to register L. The content of the memory location at the succeeding address is moved to the register H. So this is the function of LHLD address 16 bits. So this is a 3 byte instruction, direct addressing mode, machine cycles 5, T states 16. Then 10th type SHLD 16 bits, that is store H and L direct. The content of the register L is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the instruction. The content of the register H is moved to the succeeding memory location. Succeeding memory location is nothing but byte 2, byte 3 plus 1. That is succeeding memory location. So this is 3 byte instruction, direct addressing mode, machine cycles 5, number of T states 16. Then 11th instruction LDAX RP, that is load accumulator indirect. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in the register pair RP is moved to the accumulator. Here only register pair BC and DE may be specified. Okay, BC or DE register pair may be specified. So this is single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Machine cycles 2. Number of T states 7. Then 12th type STAXRP. That is store accumulator indirect. The content of the accumulator is moved to the memory location whose address is specified in register pair RP. Only register pair DC or DE may be specified. Okay. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, T states 7. Then, so this is the last instruction under this group, that is XCHG, exchange between HL and DE pair. Okay, so the function of XCHG is the content of the registers H and L are exchanged with the content of the register D and E. D register content exchanged with H. Similarly, E register content exchanged with L register. So this is the function of XCHG. It is a single byte instruction, a register addressing mode, number of machine cycles only 1, number of T states 4. The next group is arithmetic group. So under this, 20 types of instructions. So this group of instructions performs arithmetic operations on data, register and memory. Unless specified otherwise, all instructions in this group affect the 0, sign, parity carry and auxiliary carry flags according to the standard rules. Here, first type is add or, that is add register content. Okay, the content of register or is added to the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. So, this is the function of add or register. So, this is a single byte instruction. A register addressing mode, machine cycle 1, number of T-strings 4. Second type, add M, the content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is added to the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. So, this is the function of add M. It is a single byte instruction. So, this is register indirect addressing mode. It needs 2 machine cycles. Number of T-strings 7. Third type, ADI data 8 bits. That is add immediate. The content of the second byte of the instruction is added to the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. So, this is the function of ADI data 8 bits. Okay. So, this is 2 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, number of T states 7. The next one is ADCR, add register with the carry. The content of the register R and the content of the carry flag are added to the content of the accumulator. Okay, so register content, carry flag content, both are added with the content of the accumulator and the result is placed in the accumulator. So, this is single byte instruction, register, addressing mode, number of machine cycles 1, number of T-strings 4. Next one, ADCM. Here, the content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair and the content of carry flag are added to the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. Okay. So, ADCM is nothing but add memory with the carry. So, it is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 2. Number of T-strings 7. The next one is ACI data 8 bits. That is add immediate with the carry. The content of the second byte of the instruction and the content of the carry flag are added to the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. Okay, so this is 2 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, number of T-strings 7. Seventh type, SUBR. SUB is nothing but subtract register. The content of the register R is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. Okay, so the result is placed in the accumulator. This is a single byte instruction. Register addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 1. T states 4. Eighth type SUBM. That is subtract memory. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. Okay. The result is placed in the accumulator. It is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 2. T-strings 7. The ninth type SUI data 8 bits. That is subtract immediate. The content of the second byte of the instruction is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. So, this is the function of SUI data 8 bits. So, this is 2 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, number of T-strings 7. The next one is SPB R. Subtract register with borrow. The content of the register R and the content of the carry flag both are subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. This is the function of SBBR. It is a single byte instruction. Register addressing mode. Machine cycles 1. P shapes 4. Then next one is SBBM. Subtract memory with borrow. The content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair and the content of the carry flag both are subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. It is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Machine cycles 2. P shapes 7. Then 12th type SBI data 8 bits. Subtract immediate with borrow. The function of this instruction is the content of the second byte of the instruction. The content of the second byte of the instruction and the content of the carry flag are both subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. So the content of the second byte of the instruction and the content of the carry flag both are subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. It is 2 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, number of key strikes 7. 13th type INR R, increment register. The content of register R is incremented by 1. So this is the function of INR R. All the condition flags except the carry flag are affected. So this is single byte instruction, register, addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of key strikes 4. The next one is INR M. Here the content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is incremented by 1. All the condition flags except the carry flag are affected. So INRM is nothing but increment memory. So this is single byte instruction. So this is register indirect addressing mode type. Machine cycles 3. Number of key strikes 10. 15th instruction DCR R. That is decrement register. The content of register R is decremented by 1. All the condition flags except the carry flag are affected. It is a single byte instruction. Register addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 1. Number of key strikes 4. Then DCR M, that is decrement memory. The content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is decremented by 1. All the condition flags except the carry flag are affected. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycle 3, number of key strikes 10. 17th type INXRP, increment register pair. The content of the register pair RP is incremented by 1. None of the condition flags are affected. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of key strikes 6. Similarly, DCX RP, that is a decrement register pair. The content of the register pair RP is decremented by 1. None of the condition flags are affected. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of key strikes 6. Then 19th instruction DADRP. So this is nothing but add register pair to HL register. The content of register pair RP is added to the content of register pair HL. The result is placed in the register pair HL. So here carry flag only affected. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, number of machine cycles 3, number of keystrokes 10. So this is the last instruction, DAA, that is decimal adjust accumulator. The function of DAA is the 8-bit binary number in the accumulator is adjusted to form 2 4-bit binary coded decimal digits by the following process. The first step is, if the value of the least significant 4 bits of the accumulator is greater than 9, or if the auxiliary carry flag is set, 6 is added to the accumulator. So this is step number 1. Step number 2, if the value of the most significant 4 bits of the accumulator is now greater than 9, or if the auxiliary carry flag is set, 6 is added to the most significant 4 bits of the accumulator. So this is the function of DAA, decimal adjust accumulator. So this is a single byte instruction, implied addressing mode, machine cycle only 1, number of keystrokes 4. So arithmetic instruction over the third group, that is logical group. So under this, 19 types of instructions available. So logical group is nothing but performs logical operations on data, registers and memory and on condition flags. All the condition flags are affected as per standard rules unless specified otherwise. So already you know the details of logical group. See the first instruction, ANA OR. ANA is nothing but AND. OR means register. So AND register. The content of register OR is logically ANDed with the content of accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is a single byte instruction. Register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of keystrokes 4. Then see the second type, ANAM. That is AND memory. The content of memory location whose address is specified in HM register pair is logically ANDed with the content of accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and the auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 2. Number of keystrokes 7. Third type, ANI data 8 bits, that is AND immediate. See, the content of the second byte of the instruction is logically ANDed with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and the auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is a 2 byte instruction. Immediate addressing mode, machine cycles 2, keystrokes 7. Similarly, XOR instructions. XOR A OR, that is exclusive OR register. So the function of XOR A OR is the content of the register OR is logically exclusive OR with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared. The auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is single byte instruction. Register addressing mode. Machine cycles 1. Number of keystrokes 4. Next type, that is fifth instruction. XOR A M. Exclusive OR memory. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is logically exclusive with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is here. Auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. It is a single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Action cycles 2. Key states 7. Sixth type XRI data 8 bits. That is exclusive or immediate. The content of the second byte of the instruction is logically exclusive or with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and the auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. It is a 2-byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, machine cycles 2, number of key states 7. So these are all exclusive OR type. The next 3 instructions are OR, logically OR. The first one is, that is the 7th type is ORAR, OR register. The content of register OR is logically OR with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and the auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of key states 4. Next one is ORAM, that is OR memory. The content of memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is logically OR with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is cleared and auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 2, number of key states 7. Ninth type ORI data 8 bits, that is OR immediate. The content of the second byte of the instruction is logically OR with the content of the accumulator. The result is placed in the accumulator. The carry flag is clear and auxiliary carry flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. It is a 2-byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, number of machine cycles 2, number of key states 7. Then 10th instruction, CMP OR, that is compare register. See, the content of register OR is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. Okay, the first function is the content of register OR is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The accumulator remains unchanged. The carry and the zero flags are affected as follows. If accumulator is less than register content. Okay, if accumulator content is less than register content, carry flag is set. Second condition, if accumulator is equal to register content, zero flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of key states 4. Next one, that is 11th type, CMPM, that is compare memory. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in HL register pair is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The accumulator remains unchanged. The carry and the zero flags are affected as follows. If the content of the accumulator is less than the memory content, that is HL register content, the carry flag is set. If accumulator content is equal to memory content means, that is HL register content, the zero flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. It is a single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 2, number of key states 7. 12th instruction, CPI data 8 bits, that is compare immediate. the content of the second byte of the instruction is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. Okay, so the content of the second byte of the instruction is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. The accumulator remains unchanged. The carry and zero flags are affected as follows. If accumulator content is less than byte 2 content, carry flag is set. If accumulator content is equal to byte 2 content, zero flag is set. Other flags are affected as per standard rules. So this is 2 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, machine cycles 2, number of T states 7. Next one is RLC. RLC is nothing but rotate left. The content of the accumulator is rotated left one position. Okay, the low order bit and the carry flag are both set to the value shifted out of the high order bit position. Only the carry flag is affected. See, this is RLC diagram. So, this is accumulator content before execution. So, RLC is nothing but rotate accumulator left. So, every bit of the accumulator is shifted one bit left and the MSB bit of the accumulator is copied into the carry flag, is copied into the carry flag and into the A0th bit. So, this is A0th bit. So, this is A7th bit. Okay. So, this is before execution. After execution of RLC instruction, the content of the accumulator and carry flag will be like that. See here, this one moves to this bit, this one moves to this bit, this one moves to this bit, this one moves to here, this zero moves to here, like that. See the second diagram. So the last bit, that is A7th bit value is 1 before execution, whereas after execution, the last bit is 0. The same value will be copied here, that is the A7th bit value copied, the carry flag also, as well as A0th bit. So, this is the function of RLC. So, RLC means rotate accumulator left, accumulator content is rotated left side, that is RLC. So, this is single byte instruction, this is implied addressing mode, number of machine cycles 1. Number of T states 4. The next one is, that is the 14th type is RRC. So RRC is nothing but rotate right. So rotate right means the content of the accumulator is rotated right one position. So that is called rotate right. So this is the function of RRC, rotate accumulator right. Every bit of the accumulator is shifted one bit right. And the LSB bit of the accumulator is copied into the carry flag and into the D7th bit. See here, D7th bit copies to D6. D7th bit moves to D6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 0. 0th bit moves to carry flag as well as 7th bit. Okay, so this is before execution, this is after execution. After execution of RRC. So this is single byte instruction, implied addressing mode, number of machine cycles 1, number of T states 4. Then RAL, rotate left through carry. The content of the accumulator is rotated left one position through carry flag. So the low order bit is set equal to carry flag and the carry flag is set to the value shifted out of the high order bit. So only carry flag is affected. See the diagram. RAL, rotate accumulator left through carry. Every bit of the accumulator is shifted one bit left and the MSB bit of the accumulator is copied into the carry flag and the carry flag value is copied into the A0th bit. Okay, so this is A0th bit. So A0th bit moves to A1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7. 7th bit moves to carry flag. Carry flag content moves to A0th bit. So this is before execution of RAL instruction. This is after execution of RAL instruction. It is a single byte instruction, implied addressing mode, question cycles 1, number of T states 4. 16th instruction RARM, that is rotate right through carry. The function of RARM is the content of the accumulator is rotated right one position through the carry flag. The high order bit is set equal to the carry flag and the carry flag is set to the value shifted out of the low order bit. Only the carry flag is affected. See the diagram. So this is the RAR before execution. So D7th bit moves to D6, A7th bit moves to A6, A6 to A5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 0, 0th bit moves to carry flag, carry flag content moves to A7th bit. Okay, so this is before execution of RAR instruction, after execution of RAR instruction. So this is the comparison of RLC, RRC, RAL and RAR. See RLC and RRC. So here RLC and RRC, L means left, rotate left. RR means rotate right. Okay. So here A0th bit moves to A1, A1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7. Then 7th bit moves to carry as well as 0th bit. Whereas in case of RRC, A7th bit moves to 6, A7th bit moves to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 0, 0th bit moves to carry flag as well as A7th bit. Then similarly RAL, so RAL means rotate accumulator left through carry. Here 0th bit moves to 1. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7th bit moves to carry. Carry bit value moves to A0th bit. Similarly, RAR, that is rotate accumulator right side through carry. Here, 7th bit moves to 6, 6 to 5, 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to 0. 0th bit moves to carry flag. And carry flag content moves to 7th bit. So this is the comparison of RLC, RRC, RAL and RAR. Next instruction CMA, complement accumulator. The content of the accumulator are complemented. 0 bits become 1 and 1 bits become 0. No flags are affected. So this is single byte instruction, implied addressing mode. Machine cycles 1, number of T states 4. 18th type, that is CMC, is complement carry. The carry flag is complemented. No other flags are affected. So this is single byte instruction, implied addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 1, number of T states 4. So this is the last instruction, STC, that is set carry. So the carry flag is set to 1. No other flags are affected. So this is single byte instruction. So this is implied addressing mode. Machine cycles 1. Number of T states 4. So logical group of instructions over the 4th group, that is branch group. Under this 8 types of instructions. This group of instructions alters normal sequential program flow. Condition flags are not affected by any instruction in this group. Branch instructions are two types. The first one is unconditional branch instruction. Second one is conditional branch instructions. Unconditional branch instructions simply performs specific operations on the program counter. So conditional branch instruction examines the status of one of the four flags to determine if the specified branch is to be executed. Okay. So the condition that may be specified as follows. So NZ means not zero, P means parity, 0 means zero flag, NC means no carry, C indicates carry flag, PE means a parity even, P letter means plus, that is a sign flag. Okay, like that. See one by one. The first type is JMP address 16 bits. So this is unconditional jump instruction. Controllers transfer to the instruction whose addresses specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the parent instruction. That is the function of JMP address. So this is 3 byte instruction. Immediate addressing mode. Machine cycle is 3. Number of T states. The next one is J condition address 16 bits. So this is conditional jump instruction. If the specified condition is true, control is transferred to the instruction whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the parent instruction. Otherwise, control continues sequentially. So this is 3 byte instruction, immediate addressing mode, machine cycles 2 or 3, number of T states 7. Then third type, call address 16 bits. That is call instruction. So here, the function of call instruction is the high order 8 bits of the next instruction address are moved to the memory location whose address is 1 less than the content of the register SP. Okay, then the low order 8 bits of the next instruction address are moved to the memory location whose address is 2 less than the content of register SP. So SP is nothing but stack pointer. Then the content of the register SP is decremented by 2. Okay, the content of the register SP is decremented by 2. Control is transferred to the instruction whose address is specified in byte 2 and byte 3 of the parent instruction. So this is 3 byte instruction, immediate or register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 5, number of T states 18. The fourth one is condition address 16 bits, that is condition call. If the specified condition is true, the action specified in the call instruction are performed, otherwise control continues sequentially. So this is 3 byte instruction, immediate or register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles either 2 or 5, T states either 9 or 18 in the furthest. Then fifth instruction, return instruction. RET means return. The content of the memory location whose address is specified in register SP is moved to the low order 8 bits of the register PC. So PC means program counter. SP means stack pointer. The content of the memory location whose address is 1 more than the content of register SP is moved to the high order 8 bit of the register PC. The content of register SP is incremented by 2. So this is single byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Number of machine cycles 3. Number of T states 10. The next one is, that is the sixth type, or condition, that is conditional return instruction. If the specified condition is true, the actions specified in the return instructions are performed. Otherwise, control continues sequentially. So this is single byte instruction, a register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles either 1 or 3, T states either 6 or 12 needed for this. Then, 7th one, RSTN, that is restart instructions. The high order 8 bits of the next instruction address is moved to the memory location whose address is 1 less than the content of the register SP. The low order 8 bits of the next instruction address is moved to the memory location whose address is 2 less than the content of the register SP. The content of register SP is incremented by 2. The control is transferred to the instruction whose address is 8 times n. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 3, T states 5. So this is the last type, PCHI, move H and L to program counter. The content of register H is moved to the high order 8 bits of the register PC. The content of register L is moved to the low order 8 bits of the register PC. So this is the function of PCHL. So it is a single byte instruction. So this is a register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, T states 6. The last group is stack IO and machine control group. So under this, 14 types of instructions available. This group of instructions include maintaining the stack, reading input port value, writing to the output port, setting and clearing interrupt mask, and setting interrupt flag, clearing interrupt flag, except the pop PSW instruction. All the other instructions do not affect the conditional flags. Let's see one by one. The first one is push RP. That is push instruction. The content of the high order register pair RP is moved to the memory location whose address is 1 less than the content of register SP. The content of low order register of register pair RP is moved to the memory location whose address is 2 less than the content of register SP. The stack pointer is decremented by 2. Okay, the stack pointer is decremented by 2. So this is simple byte instruction. Register indirect addressing mode. Action cycles 3. Number of T-states 12. The next one is push PSW. The content of the accumulator is moved to the memory location whose address is 1 less than the content of register SP. The content of the condition flags are assembled into a processor status word and the word is moved to the memory location whose address is 2 less than the content of register SP. The stack pointer is decremented by 2. So this is the function of push PSW. So it is a single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 3, T-states 12. Then third type, pop RP, pop off stack to register pair. The content of memory location whose address is specified by the content of register SP is moved to the low order register of register pair RP. The content of the memory location whose address is 1 more than the content of register SP is moved to the high order register of register pair RP. The content of SP is incremented by 2. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycle 3, T-states 10. Then pop PSW, pop processor status word. The content of the memory location whose address is specified by the content of the register SP is used to restore the conditional flags. The content of the memory location whose address is 1 more than the content of the register SP is moved to the accumulator. The content of stack pointer is incremented by 2. This is a single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, number of machine cycles 3, number of T-states 10. Fifth type, XTHL, exchange stack top with HL register. The content of the L register is exchanged with the content of the memory location whose address is specified by the content of the register SP. The content of the H register is exchanged with the content of the memory location whose address is 1 more than the content of SP. So this is single byte instruction, register indirect addressing mode, machine cycles 5, number of T states 16. Sixth one, SP HL register. The content of register H and L are moved to stack pointer. So this is single byte instruction, register addressing mode, machine cycles 1, number of T states 6. Seventh type, import, that is input data to accumulator. Okay, the content of the input port whose address is specified in second byte of the instruction are loaded into the accumulator. So this is the function of import. So this is 2 byte instruction, direct addressing mode, number of machine cycles 3, number of T states 10. Eighth type, output, output data from accumulator. The content of the accumulator are moved to the output port whose address is specified in the second byte of the instruction. Okay, so it is a 2 byte instruction, direct addressing mode, number of machine cycles 3, number of T states 10. Ninth instruction, that is HALT instruction, HLT means a HALT instruction. The remaining instructions do not have addressing modes. Okay, so the processor halt means the processor is stopped. The registers and the flags are not affected here. It is a single byte instruction. It needs one more machine cycles. Then number of keys raised 5. No addressing mode. Similarly, NOP. NOP is nothing but no operation. No operation is performed. The registers and flags are not affected after the execution of NOP instruction. It is a single byte instruction. Machine cycle 1. Number of keys raised 4. The 11th instruction EI. So already you know EI. That is enable interrupt. The interrupt system is enabled following the execution of next instruction. So it is a single byte instruction. Machine cycle 1, T-shapes 4. The next one is DI, disable interrupt instruction. The interrupt system is disabled immediately following the execution of DI instruction. It is a single byte instruction. It needs only one machine cycle and 4 T-shapes. Then 13th instruction, that is RIM, read interrupt mask. The RIM instruction loads the data into the accumulator relating to the interrupts and the serial input. This data contains the following information. The first one is the current interrupt mask status for the RST 5.5, RST 6.5 and RST 7.5 all the interrupts. Then current interrupt enables flag status accepted immediately following the trap interrupt. And third point is a hardware interrupt pending on the RST 5.5, RST 6.5, the RST 7.5 lines. Then fourth point is a serial input data. So these are the data available in RIM instructions. Then last type, that is a SIM instructions, set interrupt mask. Okay, the last type, that is a SIM instructions, set interrupt mask. The execution of the SIM instruction uses the content of the accumulator, which must be previously loaded to perform the following functions. Program the interrupt mask for RST 5.5, 6.5, 7.5 hardware interrupt. Then reset the edge trigger RST 7.5 input latch. Then after that, load the SOD output latch. So this is the function of SIM, that is set interrupt mask. So these are the types of instructions available in 8085 microprocessor.